My guest this week is Ian Pryor of the National Republican Congressional Committee, who is in New Hampshire this week. Thanks so much for coming in, Ian.
Thanks for having me, James.
Of course, New Hampshire's got consistently two competitive congressional races, the first district and the second. What are you finding? Obviously, two Democratic incumbents in those seats. How's the recruitment going for Republicans?
Well, you know, I think both of those seats offer interesting prospects. Annie Custer's obviously had her problems early on, whether it was before the election with a campaign worker, and then, of course, after the election, as you reported, with the $44,000 in late tax payments. So we think that that's a seat that's particularly vulnerable because of Annie Custer. You move over to the first district, you have someone like Carol Shea Porter, who, you know, she either doesn't understand or doesn't care about the makeup of her district, which is moderate to Republican leaning, and she votes consistently the party line in Congress. There've been a number of bipartisan bills. She hasn't voted in a bipartisan manner, despite her claims to the contrary.
Of course, in the second district against Annie Custer, we already have one announced candidate who came on and sitting in the chair you did to right there just to announce that he's going to run for Congress. That's former House Speaker Bill O'Brien. We don't have a candidate yet to run against Carol Shea Porter. It's still very early in the cycle. Do you think that we'll have Republican primaries in both seats?
You know, I'm not really sure. I mean, we've heard Bill O'Brien, we've heard Gary Lambert in the second district. The NRCC as a policy doesn't get involved in primaries. But, you know, both are...
You have better information than I do, so I don't know if you thought there's going to be a lot of candidates in there, or you think it's going to be...
You know, I'm not really sure. We've had a chance to meet with both Mr. O'Brien and Mr. Lambert. You know, we'll see how that plays out. They're both well qualified, and I think both will have an excellent opportunity to knock off Annie Custer in that seat.
And of course, on the other side, we're looking a lot at Chris Sununu, obviously the son of a former governor and the brother of a former U.S. senator. What are the chances you think he gets in this race?
You know, we haven't gotten a chance to speak with Chris. You know, we had a chance to catch up with former Congressman Ginta, who, of course, is involved with his IBC right now, and I think he's passionate about that. But we'll wait and see how that shakes out over the next couple of months and who's interested and who isn't.
Great. Thanks so much for coming in. Now, you can read more about politics at WMUR.com/political scoop. That's also where you can find an extended version of this interview. That does it here for TV. Now back to you. I want to have a few more minutes here with you online. Let's talk about the context of these New Hampshire seats. So first off, how many seats of the 435 in Congress, how many right now are going to be competitive?
Well, you know, I think that there are 15 incumbent Democrats in seats that are Republican leaning. There are seven incumbent Democrats that are in seats where, you know, the Republican presidential candidate has won the past three times.
Wow.
The two New Hampshire seats, especially the first district, that's an even or a Republican plus one. So that certainly is a target always. And then obviously District 2, you know, with the individual kind of issues that Annie Custer has, makes that seat appealing as well. So, you know, I think you'd be hard pressed to find really two incumbent members that have been as mistake prone and unrepresentative of their district as the two members in New Hampshire. And I think we're gonna spend our resources wisely in New Hampshire.
Anytime you have an incumbent president, tends to have his party not perform as well when it comes to midterms. Obviously, 2014 is going to be a midterm. Do you have any sense, and we're talking about a year and a half away from now, but any particular big scale issues that may be driving the conversation? We've been talking about immigration lately. We've been talking about guns lately. One person even suggested today that healthcare could be a sleeper issue.
Yeah, I absolutely agree. I think healthcare, you know, the Obamacare debate has sort of up until this point has come in two phases. The first was passage. The second was, you know, kind of the debate about repeal. I think the big issue over the next election is going to be about implementation. We've already seen a battle over additional Medicare Advantage cuts this past week. You know, there are going to be significant Medicare cuts that are going to hit in 2014. Cuts that Democrats voted for when they supported Obamacare. I think premiums are going to rise in a lot of areas. And when people start to feel the effects in their paycheck from Obamacare, that's going to be something that is really going to be an issue in this election, I believe.
In New England, in the six states of New England, you're from Rhode Island originally.
Right.
Are these the only two seats that are really kind of competitive in New England? Or
no, Massachusetts 6.
It's obviously
six.
A very big Democratic area. So.
Certainly, you know, we're looking at Massachusetts 6 as well. That was a one-point race where John Tierney just eked out a victory.
Massachusetts.
Correct. And, you know, that's an area where, you know, in a non-presidential year, there could be a different result. Yeah. The 5th District of Connecticut, which is right on the border of New York, another close race. And I also think that the 2nd District of Maine might be an area where we could have some success in 2014.
Do we have any Republicans in New England now? No.
There are no sitting Republican congressmen.
Well, you have your work cut out for you.
We do. but, you know, we're confident there are some good opportunities foremost here in New Hampshire.
And when you come up, what do you guys do in New Hampshire when you're here?
You know, we got a chance to meet with some of the officials of the state party. As I said, we met with both Gary Lambert and Bill O'Brien. Mm. You know,
Frank Ginta, you mentioned. Yeah.
Yep, that's right. I had coffee with Frank. And, you know, I'd go around and meet some of the various people in the media and really just, you know, get our names out there and get a feel for the district.
Well, hope you had a good trip.
I did.
Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching WMUR.com.